Good morning, everyone. Yes, it's Nikki again, doing a live with you this morning. So excited to be here. Today I'm going to be talking to you about Won't You Be My Neighbor? And it's in honor, of course, of Fred Rogers, who was a television personality who taught us so much about life and love. And my personal favorite, he had a way with dealing with controversial issues such as race and really bringing that to light in a really fun way with play and with laughter. And he used children a lot in the way that he talked. But before I really go into the live, I just want to introduce myself. I'm Nikki. I'm the creative director of Transform Nursing. And my work is really all around bringing nurses into these deep and honest conversations about race and class in healthcare to help us change the dynamics in health equity. And as much as we want to do that with our history in this country, with deep racial intolerance and injustice and cultural misunderstanding, we have a lot to learn as nurses about how we can help our patients achieve total health and wellness. And my work really is about bringing that level of awareness to issues that are often controversial and using creative tension to really spur nurses and other healthcare professionals to action. Hey Shannon, good to see you on. Thanks for joining. You can find out more about me at my website, www.transformnursing.com. If you can hear me, hit like so that I know that you can hear. And if you like what I'm saying, give me a wow or a thumbs up. And even more importantly, if you really think this is something that somebody else needs to hear, please share it. So tag someone in your comments, let them know, hey, this is a great conversation that we're having so that they can join as well. Feel free, of course, to tell me where you're listening from. I love to learn more about my listeners, so share with me about that. And then my first question of the day is, thank you for my love. And my first question is, do you think being neighborly is outdated? Like eating at the dinner table with everybody. Good morning. Do you think that being neighborly is outdated, like eating at the dinner table? I know we grew up sort of eating around dinner tables. And then, of course, as we got older, it wasn't as much of a tradition. And when I look at my neighbors, even today, I'm friendly enough with them, but there's really not anyone that's, I would say, a neighbor where I'm like, oh my gosh, you can dog sit for me when I'm gone. Sure, you can help me with my groceries to the car, but do I know my neighbors by name? You know, am I that comfortable with them? And I want to know, are you friendly? Are you friendly in your workspaces with other people that you work with? Do you tolerate differences in ideas and thoughts and in behaviors? I just had a post on my website, actually on my Facebook page, which was really great, in response to a video about a webinar that I have that I'm offering, and I'll share that with you. And this nurse basically, or maybe not a nurse, I'm not even sure if she is a nurse, she said, go away, you make nurses look bad. And I'm smiling only because that kind of stuff is actually inspiring for me. It's helpful for me because I get to see that there is actually an audience for this, that there are people that really need to learn this and kind of have a better understanding of what it is that I do. And I didn't get mad. I actually got excited about it. It means nurses, like I said, are seeing what I'm saying and already causing some type of a response. Good morning. And what that response said to me was, I don't want to see this problem. And if you're bringing it to light, I don't want to see that I have patients who are suffering because I refuse to actually see them. And since this is about Mr. Rogers, won't you be my neighbor? How might do you think Mr. Rogers teach us to have better relationship with our patients? Could he teach us something about having better relationship with our patients? I think he would insist upon it. I think it would be relentless about it, and I think he would be relentless in the pursuit of kindness one towards another. He spent 40 years teaching us the importance of curiosity and imagination. He was an ordained minister. He introduced children to concepts from cooperation to diversity to racial tolerance, and he liked to help people boost self-esteem, and he used song and all kinds of other creative ways to do that. He took all of these elements that sort of make good television and did just the opposite, right? So he took a low production value. He's a simple set. He was an unlikely star, but it worked. And he didn't need to put a whole lot of extra things into it. He didn't wear a funny suit or anything like that or jump through hoops. What he was teaching us that was, how do we have relationships with people? And that's something that I think nurses can really benefit from. And what are some things that I learned from Mr. Rogers? I learned that kindness is gentle and that we need it. He showed us that it is simply and quietly and elegantly, it's something that we can do, and it's possible for each one of us to do one for another. And it's a challenge, but also it's an obligation for us to remember how important that kindness is. He also taught me, and hopefully us, that people do want to hear the message. People want to hear the message of social justice. And there's no way that he would have stayed on television if people didn't want to hear the message, right? Like, That's what people watch television for. It drives ratings. So people wanted to know more about Mr. Rogers. But what I love about him is his subtlety and the way he communicated about social justice. And it tells me that even in times when I don't know if people are getting my message, that it's not the time to stop trying. And that kindness, especially random acts of kindness, are vital if we are to see people as deserving of our compassion, to see people as deserving of our knowledge and our competency and our skill in delivering them even better healthcare. And another thing that Mr. Rogers has taught me as an influential leader is that influential leaders are persistent. The message is clear and the behaviors support the message. I've had people reach out to me because of my course, the Nurses Influential Leadership Lab, and they've told me, I want to be an influential leader, but I'm just tired. Like, I'm burnt out. I don't know what to do. And I get that, right? The work that I do is largely around race and class and healthcare. And the work can be very exhausting at times. But when I feel that way, I do take a break. I pause. I do my self-care. Good morning, Michelle. Good to see you on. I do my self-care and then I come right back to the message, because the message is what this is all about. And I don't do this work necessarily because it's what I want to do all the time, right? It's what's required of us as nurses. It's what's required of us as professionals. When police stop killing black men in the street, when children can go to school and be assured that they're getting the same equitable education, and when schools are safe, and when I, as a black nurse and leader, get the same respect as a white male physician, then I can really take a break, right? But until then, this is the only work that I believe that I can do as a nurse, and it's the work that works for me. And just like Mr. Rogers, his message was clear on his view on racism. If we remember back on the episode that he did with Francois Clemens, who was actually the first black person to have a recurring role on a television children's set, Mr. Rogers was showing that blacks and whites don't have anything that's really different. And of course, in the early 60s, when there was all the unrest, there was a time when black kids were being kicked out of pools. And what Mr. Rogers did in a very subtle way was he brought on this black police officer onto the show, made him a part of the show, invited him and his wife into the home, and then went outside in a little kiddie pool and was washing his feet, and just because it was hot outside. And then he invited the police officer to do the same. Of course, this is a black person. And he's like, well, I can't really do that. I don't have a towel. You know, I can't really do it. He goes, no, I'll share mine. Okay. And he did this at the height of unrest. And what he was doing is, as an influential leader, he was calling to attention that these are things that we have to point out and that we have to be willing to move through and kind of push through, right? And what he did was he used his position, he used his influence, and he used his power to show everyone how foolish it was to allow fear and indifference to drive behavior. He took a chance, right? Just like we have to take a chance. Every day that I'm on here, that I'm doing this work, I'm taking a chance. I'm taking a chance that some people will listen to me. I'm taking a chance that some people will not listen to me. And people could have stopped watching his show. His rating could have gone down, but they didn't. He stayed on, and he stayed on television for 40 years, and he achieved all kinds of awards, which says to me that there is still hope for us. I get to teach nurse leaders how to use their impact, their privilege, and their influence to correct inequity, right? I recently did a podcast, actually, Michelle, I'm about to mention you, with an amazing nurse and entrepreneur, Michelle Rhodes, who is actually on right now of Nursepreneur Nation, and it was just phenomenal. This podcast is my podcast that I just launched. It's called Transform Nursing, and before we even did the launch, before we did the podcast together, Michelle was like, well, I'm not really sure, you know, what I have to say about social justice. And when you hear the podcast, you're going to hear all about it, that she has so much to say and she has so much to share, even in her amazing work that she does with new nurses and people who are really just trying to be out there and kind of advocate for themselves and learn how to be entrepreneurs. You definitely have to check her out on Nursepreneur Nation. She's pretty incredible. And I'm so thankful that there is so much to say. I'm so thankful that we can find synergy, that it's not always about rallying and marching and, you know, carrying your signs, right? Sometimes justice is found in subtleties. It's found in small things that we do. So what can you do? What can I do in my own way? Well, I've learned that a lot of times many nurses don't really want to be involved in policy. There are a few of them that do, but most nurses really don't. So if you don't really want to be involved in policy, then there are other ways that you can be involved. One way that I have found to be really effective and impactful is to join an association that's doing some of this work. Campaign for Action is a great networking association for nurses who is doing this kind of work. or just stay aware of what's going on, what's happening in social media. Stay aware of the different movements, the Me Too movement, the Black Lives Matter, all kinds of movements that are going on. Stay aware, be mindful, and see how you can actually get involved. So can you do social justice work without a whole lot of commotion? You absolutely can. And that's absolutely what I'm asking people to do. For me, my work is really around education and around building bridges with partner organizations. So my work is around teaching through courses, through workshops, and helping people understand that nurses are impactful in justice work and that our voices will continue to be impactful. We are the largest group of healthcare professionals at 3 million strong, and I believe that it is going to be us that is going to turn the tide in health policy and really get people to become aware of what inequity looks like and what it means for our patients if we just stay tuned to it. So for more tips and strategies, please check out my webinar, which I'm going to post here below. That's going to teach you all about how to become a nurse leader, 4 strategies that will change your trajectory, will change your outcomes, will change your impact. And then just keep doing the work. If you want to learn how to, you know, be better at equity, read blogs, find out again what people are doing, and find a source and then get connected to that source, right? Because this work is really about connection. So I hope that you enjoyed my very short Facebook Live this morning. I didn't want to take up too much of your time. Share in your networks if this is something that's been useful for you. Thanks so much, everybody. Happy Monday.